see the shakers. We're worse than an earthquake.
Like Elvis, just like the Beatles, now it's Johnny Rotten and the Sex Pistols and countless others. And we're making kind of like new rules.
My name is John, and he's from the Sex Pistols.
Is it a historic event?
Oh, yeah.
Destroy, boss, the bike, cause I
was worth all the money we paid and all the trouble we went through to get out here.
Fuck no, they're garbage, man. You know, they're garbage.
I like it for me, but I don't think I'd recommend it to anybody.
All I can say is it was a vicious, rotten thing to do.
I've been living in Italy, and I feel like I really missed this whole movement.
I think I heard one time that they urinate on the audience one time. Why, I don't know. It just sounds goofy.
The pistols are just out of sight. I think they got a lot of balls.
It's about time we got some street fighting men here in America. It's about time we got someone to rile the people up.
It's better than homework. It's better than a lot of stuff. I mean, you know, sometimes it's kind of boring in itself, but it's something to do.
That would be a Sex Pistols holster.
I think it was great. It was short and sweet, the way I like it. Very loud, very energetic, and very nice.
Well, I thought when I saw Johnny Rotten's face, I thought I'd vomit. He's so beautiful.
Sex Pistols are using news the best way possible. I admire them for it because they've been factory workers. They'd grow up and do nothing unless they would use the news and use the media to make something of themselves, and that's finally what they're doing, and they deserve it. Y'all are taking pictures of people. They're doing things that normally doesn't happen, but you're making a big thing out of it.
Well, that's
and that's what the Sex Pistols
are
using.
Those guys can't sing worth a shit.
The Sex Pistols are well known to us as thoroughly bad news, and we'd be very circumspect about licensing any concert which they wanted to put on in London. They have appeared in London. They appeared as recently as a couple of months ago, but we impose pretty stringent conditions on the licensee of the hall where the concert took place.
What were the conditions?
There were 19 pages of them.
Now, when you spread the idea, as it's certainly been spread over this country, and I imagine over your country too, that man has, you know, this right to do whatever he wants when he wants, that is the most regressive, reactionary philosophy that you can ever, ever propagate. And the children are the sufferers. And it's no good trying to deal with punk. You'll never deal with punk. You've got to go back and you've got to look at what's happening in your society and you've got to begin to build again. See, I'm not shocked by punk. I'm shamed by it. When I see these youngsters who should be full of life and fun and adventure turning to do this, what have we done to the world?
People like me don't never have friends. Because we tell the truth, we don't care a shit about anything else. So people can't relate to us, they're scared, the media's scared to respond to us. No, I ain't got no friends, nobody. I want friends. Don't know, it's nice to know you're different from everyone else. But it has as many damn points as its good points. A lot of times I wish that I was with people and enjoying myself. Might enjoy myself anyway. I get my labour money Thursday. I end up with about £2. Play cards Thursday night. And if I win, I can go and have a drink. If I don't, I can't. And I'll stay in or I'll go and punch off someone.
Yeah!
My mum, like any mum, is sort of scared for me going out like this. And my dad is like all dads, you should have been in the war, should have been in the army, should have done this. Look at your hair, look like some puff and all this. But I used to get this before I was a punk, and I think most kids do so. They don't relate to punk as what you are. Parents are like that in England, because we won the war. So they're just kicking at you, whatever you do. You just can't be right to a parent in London.
It's all a gamble. I think that record companies are like book publishers. You have a responsibility to the public. It's not just dollars and cents. So certainly this is not a nonprofit organization. It is a successful organization. But I think that you have to expose all kind of music to people. We were going to play one date. Original intent was to play one date, which was going to be Pittsburgh. We were going to play one date and go out. And as it transpired, they had some extra free time, so we decided to do a mini tour, which of 11 cities and 11 dates, which due to difficulty with the visas, finally ended up as 7 dates in 7 cities. I think that this tour, mini tour, whatever you want to call it, very historic in nature, and I think it's changed the face of music in all aspects to come for the next few years. The American Embassy, I think due to a lot of pressure from the English government, and I'm presuming that, refused the visas on the grounds of arrest records of 4 of the members, all 4 members. There hasn't been a rock and roll group to hate for a long time. It's an antisocial group. It's something to be afraid of. At the same time, it's news and it sells their papers and sells their programs.
Banana bread recipe. Right? Ingredients: 2 laughing eyes, 2 loving arms, 2 well-shaped legs, 2 firm milk containers, 1 firm alone mixing bowl, 2 large nuts. mixing instructions. Look into laughing eyes. Spread well-shaped legs, slowly. Squeeze and massage milk containers, very gently, until fur-lined mixing bowl is well greased. Check frequently with middle finger. Add banana and gently work in and out until well creamed. Cover with nuts and sigh with relief. Bread is done when banana goes soft. Be sure to wash mixing utensils and do not lick the bowl. Warning, if bread starts to rise, leave town. I think you find most punks don't believe in heroes, that's why they have the courage, or whatever you want to call it, to walk down the street looking totally ridiculous. You're just trying to get the message across, it don't matter what you got on, you're a human being and you're messed up. And your clothes, in my opinion, relate to how you feel around you. Like, someone looked at these clothes, they'd say they're fucked up clothes. And that's the idea, you're fucked up with the people and the surroundings around you. You get too much of it, society and all this. Freddie had his stuff and Steve had his stuff. And we just all got together and started mucking about, making tunes, play 12 records and things like that. Then we decided we'd go out over to go and shoot the pub. Very poor.
The important aspect of punk is that it's difficult nowadays to become regarded as man as opposed to boy. What the anthropologists call the rite de passage in this society has become fudged. And I think an awful lot of people who enjoy punk would really like to be back in those days when they could actually see physical people hacking each other to death.
I'm going to have to ask you to get back out of the door and let people get the tickets to get in.
I've worked in records for years, and this is a publicity stunt. They oversold the tickets because punk is not a valid form of music here in the States. I mean, it's a vaguely political thing in England, and they come over here, and the only way they can create confusion is by fraud, by overselling too many tickets. So, I mean, you got all these people out here that are all mad, you know, because they've been taken. That's their cause. It's not punk.
The excitement that the Stones got when they first started is comparable to the excitement, the media excitement and the consumer excitement that the Sex Pistols are receiving now. The guys are really, really nice people. They're punks, but they're really nice people. The only thing I have never seen them do or that I don't know that they've ever done is thrown up on anybody, but everything else is true. They spit, they use vulgar language. Everything else but the throwing up is true.
Hey, Steve!
Yeah?
Yeah. Hey, I've been nicked. I've got a gun. Sorry, he's nicked me. Can we just,
Hey, up, Austin! Steven, what kind of badge you got?
I don't know.
Safety department.
Safety department. That's very good.
Your job.
Say goodbye. Say goodbye. What's your impression of America at this point?
Load of shit.
This idea that the punk rock scene is born of social protest may or may not be true until they actually learn how to speak and enunciate the Queen's English and put their arguments forward in an intelligible fashion. I shall be quite unable to judge the validity of what they are alleged to think. If they've got something to contribute, why don't they get off their big fat backsides and contribute it? What is all this, if I may use the term, because I think it's offensive in America, but what is all this crap I keep hearing from people who tell me what they want, who keep talking to me about their rights? What about what they're prepared to give? What about their duties? Why don't we hear a little bit more about that? And then perhaps we would have a society in which we could all take a pride.
Guns and ammunition.
Memphis, Tennessee. Elvis's home. Today's his birthday.
We're here to see Elvis on his birthday.
Well, I just want to come out and take some pictures and just be out here.
I think he was a great guy. Felt like a brother to him, even though I never met him. And, if you excuse me now, I just want to go in and pay my respects.
He was a great person. We loved him very much.
Where's he now? He's resting in the Rose Garden.
What's your favorite Elvis song?
Are You Lonesome Tonight?
Have you yourself ever seen a punk group perform?
Oh, yes. Six or seven times, I think it is now.
Which groups?
These dreadful twerps, the Sex Pistols, I've had the enormous displeasure of seeing them twice. And there are other groups whose names I happily can't remember. Can't tell you how pleased it makes me.
Why do you think that punk rock occurred?
Well, I have a very basic attitude towards this. How about money? How about money? They're not poverty-stricken, these boys, are they? They don't do it for the money? I think they do.
The idea of having a job or having a career has never occurred to me, because since I left school, I always saw jobs in terms of saving up to buy equipment. Right, so I've never actually felt involved. Like, you know, when I've had a job, it's because I'm saving up to buy a guitar or buy an amplifier. You know what I mean? So I feel I've never experienced the idea of actually being in a job, you know, and wanting to be, you know, head of Tesco's or something. You know what I mean? Like stacking shelves, you know, hoping to be like chief stacker. It sounds a bit stupid, but for me, rock and roll and being in the group and living the life is the most important thing that comes above everything else.
The Greyhound's rocking out tonight to maximum rockabilly. When two punks choose to risk the subway for a tube to Piccadilly. Whose efforts stir fast gangs for glory, another dumb casualty. Having fun in South of Six. Hit a flick, knife flicks. Oh, kiss me. Deadly. Tonight. Another battle was won and lost down the Bishop's End last night. The spotlights pick the kids in triumph with a thousand scars in flight.
The band recorded their album in a room which is a bit like a converted garage, about maybe 15 foot deep and 10 foot wide, and there's bits hanging off the ceiling. It doesn't matter. I think technology in the music industry has advanced so much in the last 5 years that it's almost become an end in itself for a lot of major bands. I don't think you need to record records that sound as good and as clean as many bands have done in the past to make good music. And in fact, that highly technological recording process gets in the way of making good, exciting, live, launching music.
Having fun! Well, the hills make night flicks. Order violence for a fix. Discovers teenage sex. Try shooting up for kicks.
Rock is just a thermometer of our inward condition. Sin isn't something that we do, but sin is a disease that's passed on.
Give us a ring. BR52561, man. Be cool. I'll
Yeah. but we're saying we're with the Dicks.
What are you doing?
Theatrical. I'm gonna do this exorcism thing. I'm gonna get in a trunk, and then I'm gonna come out and spit pea soup all over the place. And then at the end, I'm Bicentennial Boogie. I'm gonna have whipped cream and shoot it on all the bass players and all that, you know, in the audience and stuff.
How long have you been performing?
Oh, not too long, about a year.
How old are you?
12.
Our dinner jacket, which we call urban camouflage. Let's see, it's got the city collars in it. You never get away with this in the country. This is what we call the zip shirt. Gives you plenty of easy access to your partner or yourself. It's lots of fun. You can't get the zipper working right now. It'll feel all right.
These pants have buckles all around them.
Buckles and straps. You can strap it across like that if you want to tie your partner up. Some of the ones that I've seen actually do a binding in the arms. We don't carry that right at this point. It's one of the earlier things that we have. Like when you dance, when you grab your partner, you know, do the strangling. Seen that, maybe. These are felt pants. Here's the police again. Riot. Now let's see, where's filth? Filth.
Part of the enjoyment of going to see a punk band is the intimacy. See, in England, when the kids watch the punk bands, they spit at the performers. You know, that's their show of affection, which the band themselves don't particularly care for. All my family in Russia weren't allowed to go to school, and they weren't allowed to go out, so they used to amuse themselves by playing instruments in their homes, and they would go out and hide themselves out as little bands. And in fact, Many of the major orchestras in this country have relatives of mine playing bassoons and cellos and things like that. Very much about, I know there's a group called the Flying Spiders in Holland, a group called Brood in Holland, and in France, a band called Telephone, a band called Asphalt Jungle, Television, a group called the Talking Heads, the Erasers with Susan Eraser. My favorite group that's out now is a group called The Clash, the Avengers from San Francisco. In New York, there's the Ramones, Suicide, Teenage Jesus, and the Jerks. Japan, I don't know about. I get much more pleasure out of turning somebody on to this kind of music than to ring up the cashiers. I'm an attorney, and I'm financially independent of the store.
Before I came here, I had definite opinions, and I suppose they were very negative about the Sex Pistols. I've been here, and I've talked to a lot of people. Those opinions have changed drastically now from negative to sort of a mellow type situation. And really, I guess now all I can do is the only thing that we are supposed to do as news reporters, and that's to wait and see what happens.
I didn't know who they were until the people started telling us, the morning news and the Times there, and everybody called us, hey, you got the Sex Pistols? And I said, yeah, I guess so. Who are they? They said, well, they're a controversial group. They do this, and they do that, and they do this. They call me at home, and, you know, they kind of upset me. And then the public started calling us, and I was rather disturbed about it. I tried to catch it, you know. I tried very hard, but... They told me there would be 3 lawsuits if I canceled it, and I said, well.
Da da da. I think your television, not the way it's made, but where it is in America, is just great. For kids of my age, and you'll find that's like 100% out of 100. You can't beat that. But over here, it's poxy. I mean, most of the programmes, our best programmes are the ones you blokes don't want in your slingers. Kojak or some shit like that. Our telly goes off at 11:30, then you've got to listen to God Save the Queen. It gets a bit monotonous after a while. And most kids ain't into 12, 2 in the morning anyway. But it still don't mean they're tired. I mean, society says you've got to be in bed at 12, which is totally wrong. If you're awake and you can't sleep, there's no reason why you shouldn't be able to switch the telly on, which you can't.
Yeah, you ask anybody and they all want to get out, man. It's just the shit ass right now.
Fucking get a job is still
like when
fucked.
we got a job.
Even if you get a job.
Get out into the radio.
Hey, man.
I'm working now and I'm still fucked. I still have to go out thieving. Get my fucking money. I'm doing. There ain't nothing to do round here. Put it this way, I go to work in the morning, get up half past 7, got be in work by 8 o'clock, come home at 5 o'clock, sometimes I do overtime, then when I come back, I just go straight home and I go straight to bed. And that's it.
You fucking
wanker. And I just wait till the morning comes, when Friday comes, like today, I went pictures, I just come back from pictures. Nothing else to do now, I'm just hanging round here. In a minute, I'll go home.
Fuck off, Billy.
Fuck off, Carter.
How old are you?
16.
16.
Can't get a job in that. Mum and dad kicks them out usually. Or they just fuck off somewhere. Round the poor suburbs of London usually. East London or North London.
Because what you're saying is totally unintelligible and he can't understand you. And we called him, so that means it's a waste of his time, so let's give him a good interview, right?
Well, do you know what I mean?
Do I know what you mean? About why he called it a day? Yeah, I know what you mean. Everybody was for Sid. I mean, Sid was like, I don't know if he saw any of the gigs, but Sid was like really shining out. And John was being like, nothing. You know, he just wasn't giving it anymore. He just wasn't, and he wasn't shaping up. He was looking awful. The way he was dressing, the way he looked horrible. He wouldn't listen to anybody. And, like, you know, I mean, Sid tried to talk to him time and time and time again. sweet kiss for you. We'll go to sleep later on. What are you looking for?
Got it. Yes, I like. Two people that I can think of I would like to play with if I'm with.
Sid.
Yeah.
Sid's not interviewing me. Please try and wake up.
Okay.
Do you want me to make you a cup of coffee?
It's my scotch. Yeah, could you?
Yes, I'll make you a cup of coffee. But will you try and fucking wake up, no, please? Because we gave him an interview.
I'll
and
do
he wanted
it.
To give him a good interview. All right? You're not talking intelligibly. You're falling asleep on your sunglasses. Wake the fuck up. He's been very ill, you know, it's hard for him to talk. I'm trying to get him to wake up and talk to you. Oh, shit. Yeah, I've been making him rest since he's back, feeding him good food. Can you wake up, please?
Yeah, okay, I'll wake up. Right, now what's the next question?
He ain't gonna drop dead, take it from me. He's just fucked up. I mean, he's been sick for 3 months that he's been on the road the whole time. I mean, look at that poster up there. He's yellow on that poster. You can see it, can't you? Sid, what are you...
Put the ashtray in the...
Yeah, you put the cigarette on the bed. What'd you say?
Put it in the ashtray.
Yeah. upset the bass player because I knew that he knew that I meant physical harm. And I have to say I was ugly about it. But he came out and hit us over the head with a bass. He was hitting us because I was going like this. Come on, buddy. And he kept going like this. And I would have been glad to take him on or his buddy Johnny. I don't care either one. And so consequently, I was taken out of the concert. I came here to openly cause dissent against the Sex Pistols because I believe negatively in what they're doing. And as far as I'm concerned, they're not worth killing.
Face and listen. You piss off, don't flipping tell me to piss off, right? Well, you get up here. Well, get on it then.
Cut it about three times, he still got nervous. What can I do? I'm made to look a cunt. I don't go up there and get nervous and make them look cunts. Ain't right that they should get nervous and make me look a cunt. Ain't what it's all about. If you can't take it, don't fucking stand the pace.
What about the audience?
They're not as good as we usually have, but, you know, they were there and we played, that's it. I don't care if one peepee turns up. And they like us. You all right? How many geezers do you give a chance to fucking get it right? I gave them three or four. I don't know if you're supposed to give them more than that. But I never. That's all you can give someone. Don't even really expect to give anyone one chance, and I don't want no one to expect to give me one chance.
Listen, listen, for fuck's sake. I'm sick of making speeches all the time. Every time I come to a gig, I've got to make a speech about fucking fighting. Every fucking time. Do you know what I think? Because I have to do these fucking speeches and fucking think, oh, he don't mean it. He's only doing it because it makes him a lot bigger, you know what I mean? I don't want to fucking keep saying, stop fighting, stop fighting. Just fucking enjoy yourselves for a change.
Mistake! A rebel!
you come in the pub as an individual and you said, but what the fuck are you trying to achieve by this, then I have to explain it to you. And then another geezer comes in the pub and I have to explain it to him. And then another geezer. But if I get on stage, then I'm telling all of them at the same time.
Listen, if you don't fucking enjoy us out of this song, we're fucking off. This one's called Boston Breaker. We'll be right back.
I'm really into it, and I'm into the punk rock scene, and they moved me. They made me shake more than I've ever shook before, and that's what makes them the best.
Yeah, what are they saying?
What are they singing? Who cares what they're singing? They're singing, who cares? Who fucking cares? Get out of here.
What are they saying?
Who, it isn't what they sing. Get out of here.
Yeah, what are they saying? Let's sing.
Get out of here. Get out. Get. I don't want to mess any cameras up. I don't want any trouble. Get the fuck out of here.
Texas, and I know Texas, and they throw you out the door because they're afraid of you. And they have the authority because they have a badge, and they have a fucking billy club and a gun. And what's it all about? It's about this. I mean, it's about fucking having a good time, and they're just so afraid of you, they gotta injure you. That's why punks carry chains, because people are constantly hassling you, and you're just into your thing, and you gotta carry things because you're constantly put up being fighting back.
What are you gonna do tonight?
I have no clue. I don't care. I do care, but you know, you can't care. You can't care at all because if you care, you'll get let down.
I think it's fun. Do you want your ears blown out some more?
And look, I told him, I said, watch. You watch. The first thing he's going to say, what am I doing here, right? And the band had so many problems at the moment. I'm like, that's the first thing he said. Fucking hell, I'm sweating.
Stand up for me, take it off.
Excuse us a second. You just have to bear with us. I hope you're not really mad.
Hmm?
Why is anything under me?
Oh, you're a
child. An interview with Sid and Nancy.
Yeah.
Sid and Nancy at home.
Please, for nobody look.
Oh.
I've been with Sid ever since the first day I ever got to England. And we're partners in crime. And we have good fun.
We wipe the shit off
and we help each other out. You know? Okay, far away, next question. And like Sid would have died 15 deaths if I hadn't been around. Because that's just, you know, the way he is. And when he's not, this is what he does when he's not with me. It's shit when people say that he can't play because he can't. He learned all the Pistols songs in 2 weeks. I mean, it just made him want to work all the more.
Hey, do you want to make a pornographic movie? Give us £100.
We made one for Sex Pistols number 3 in Huddersfield.
Yes? What, amazing.
It was great fun on a dirty floor with the, never mind the bollocks poster under us. It was great with one of those.
What were you doing? Screwing?
Sucking and big dominant submissive. Sid licking my feet. Oh no, Sid.
What?
Not even on the scene either.
I was elected, my majority is 10,000, and that does give me not only a duty to do certain things, it gives me the right to do certain things as well, and the punk rock scene better understand it, because I represent the status quo, I represent perpetuity, I represent orthodox government, I represent the democratic elective process. They represent none of those things, and that is why I and those whom I represent will win, because they can't beat us. And they're not going to beat us. It's as simple as that. It's not an arrogant statement, it's just a statement of fact.
Despite all the hassles, what was it that you thought the Pistol were trying to do? I mean, was it just like re-kick the establishment out of the arse? Sid?
Ow!
Where the fuck
Ted, damn you! Fuck!
Yeah. I'm sorry. I can't
it's
help it.
The eighth time you
spilled. I'm just so tired.
You spilled a cigarette on me, spilled coffee on me, spilled orange juice on me.
What was the next question? What was that question again?
Don't drop it on me again.
Second again. What was the question?
What are you going to do tonight?
Go over, try and get a bank nap, and then go to bed.
What are you going to try to do?
Get a banker.
What's that?
A shag, a fat.
Where?
Over the disco. Where I always go. And if you don't, you go to bed. And wait to try for tomorrow. I don't know what I want to do.